And let's now talk books. Bonnie Kim is the CEO, lead trainer, and founder of Bonnie Kim Limited, consultation and motivational company specializing in empowering people and helping businesses succeed. He's among the handful of Kenyan certified professional trainers under Institute of Human Resource Management, IHRM, and a Kenyan prolific best-selling author of 6 books. Today we review his latest book, The Power of Self-Image for Successful Students. Bonnie Kim, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
It's great to host you. Talk to us about your book, The Power of Self-Image for Successful Students, A Personal Guide for Academic Excellence.
Basically, the book is about helping the student, because if you see in business, we have business plans. And if you see in buildings, we have architect. So you see the array of the plan. But it's only in education that you find the people. The students are being told, work hard. The parents training work hard, but they don't have a name. They don't have a goal. So this is bringing them, because our mind work with images. So it's about helping the students come up with a plan to say, in English, I want to get an A. In maths, I want to get maybe a B, so that they can have a clear picture in their mind of the results they are expecting. So it's giving students a map, because if you don't know the way, all the roads leads there. And that's the challenge we have in our education today.
Yeah. So what inspired you to write about this subject?
Yeah, what motivated me to write this book, I can say I hadn't planned to write this book. But when I wrote my second book, The Born Without a Choice, I included a chapter on how to pass exams. And most teachers and parents, they ask me, Bonnie, can you do a book for students? And then I said, yes, I'll do. So I took up the challenge and I started working on that.
Right, so you're writing your target audience clearly for this book is students. Is there any specific grades you're targeting?
I'm talking to the grade that has come to self-realization, that from primary, high school, colleges, and also everybody is a student overall. Mm-hmm. I've included more on chapters to do on passing exams, how to do it, because the big challenge we have is that today you find that students are competing with others and cooperating with the poor self-image. But for me, it's the other way around. You got to cooperate with other students who are better than you and compete with yourself so that, say, this time I got these marks, I want to go to the next grade. Yeah.
In chapter 2, you're talking about if you believe you can succeed, you can. And you're quoting Mark chapter 9, verse 23, all things are possible to him who believes. And I guess that's where the aspect of self-image as well comes in.
Yeah. Okay. I'm talking that because you become what you see yourself becoming. Because if you have a poor self-image, everything you're going to interpret with the poor self-image. But if you have a positive self-image, you interpret things in that way, because it's how you see things. We become what we see. And our mind understand better in images. And you see, if you got students to believe that they deserve the best, that's what they're going to get, because they're going to work hard not to get anything, but they are going to work hard to get the best that they believe they can. So it's to get them to believe that you deserve it, and to get them to believe that, yes, you can do it and you can do it better. You see, I've seen all things are possible to him who believes. Reason being, you become what you see yourself becoming. If you see yourself poor, then you become poor.
All right, let's go now to page 87 in chapter 6 of the book. And something interesting that you say here in one of the paragraphs, that if you hate education, you will find yourself knowing almost everything happening in the life of celebrities, football, politics, and have all useless facts at your fingertips. One would argue that not everybody will get an A, and that for some people it's issues like football. That's what they're into, and that's where they excel.
You see, one thing we miss point about education is that education is about helping people to get to think. Because if you get a talented footballer but doesn't have education, how will that become a professional footballer? You find that, yes, we're in school. As much as we are flourishing, you want to know about what is happening outside the world. You have all that time. It's good you learn to balance, get to know what is needed of me today. You get, because You need to use education so that to sharpen your thinking and to sharpen the way you see things. Because yes, education is important, but education is not final, because today we misunderstand about education because we go to school so that we can use that education and remit ourselves. But education should be used to open our mindset to think better, so that if it's that footballer, he have boros, he have character, because he know he have gone through the education. He is runned, but a runned footballer.
So it really is a mind shift for Kenyans to look at, and everybody to look at education as something which opens you up, opens your worldview and how you get to look at issues and understand several issues around the world.
Yes, it's opening up your mind to think and expand your thinking capacity. Mm-hmm. And you see things in a different way, not to rely, because you say someone goes to school, learns about IT, thinks I'm an IT, and stop thinking I'm only IT. Mm-hmm. Instead of saying, yes, I run about IT, but I'm a talented musician. How can I use my IT skills to better, to make my music professionally? Mm. Yeah.
What separates the highly successful students from the average students in your view?
You see, the better performing students, they see themselves successful in their own minds. Where the poor performing students, they have a poor self-image. Someone, maybe you find along their way, affected them, criticized them, and they have lived with that criticism, and it has built a barrier in their mind that I can't do better. So they are comparing themselves with that. But you see, the highly successful student, they have a better self-image. They see themselves, I can do this, I can do better, I can thrive. And that's what they become. So it is not what they are studying, because you find even the poor student, they study a lot, but simply because they have a mental block in their mind, it prevents them from doing better, because when they see exam, they just, I can't do it.
All right, and this is not the first book you've written. So tell us about how many books you've written and what about?
Yeah, I have 7 books so far. My first book is The Greatest Secret. Everything is created twice. First mental, second physical. The other book, second book, is Born Without Choice. That me and you, nobody wrote a catalog on whose parent to be born to. But despite that, how we live our life after being born is upon us. So we are the one who choose how we're going to spend our life after being born. The choice is yours. And my third book, The Power of Self-Image, talks about we become what we see ourselves becoming. The fourth book is What is True Love? Because a lot of us, we're asking, what is love? What is true love? And I found that the hardest thing to find in life is not to find a soulmate, but to find the kind of soul that you are before you find its mate. Because if you don't know who you are, how are you going to find someone who is going to accept you the way you are when you don't know yourself? That's why you find, I am looking for myself, my partner is looking for herself. So we don't find each other, because even when we stay together, we are still continuous searching for ourselves. So the best thing is first find yourself and then find the mate.
Okay, and you've penned down a couple of books, of course, on different subjects. So what's your writing cycle like? What gets you started on writing a book? Is it an idea from somebody? Do you wake up in the middle of the night and, you know, start writing?
My writing cycle is simple, because my writing cycle goes with self-image. It all rotates in one thing: self-image, self-actualization, and self-development. And you find that most of the books you see, like now, this book, The Power of Self-Image for Successful Student, was inspired by the second book, Born Without Choice. People told me, write about this. See, like my 7th book for customer service, and the other upcoming book for sales, I've been doing that in the organization, and people challenge me, Bonnie, you train on customer service and sales always. Why don't you write a book on customer service and sales? So, and also questions, because sometimes people ask you questions and you sit down and think and you get another question. You find that, wow, why don't I write about that and share that? So it comes now, is it matching my criteria or my cycle of writing, which is self-image?
Okay. And having written several books and your experience with the Kenyan market, do Kenyans read?
Yeah, Kenyans have started to read, and we have a growing reading culture. The challenge we are having is that you find that we have a book borrowing culture. You find one book has been read by 100 people, and you find now, I always challenge people, I tell them that a house without books is like a body without a soul. You find that if you want to plant a reading culture and to nurture a reading culture in your home as a parent, what are you reading now? You ask yourself, what kind of books are in your house? And do you have a bookshelf? Yes, we have very good displays for our TVs, but where do we have? Do we have bookshelf in our homes?
And finally, where can this book be found?
Yep. The book is called The Power of Self-Image for Successful Students. You can find it at all Nakumatt branches, Textbook Center, Savanis, Joshi bookshops, and all bookshops in all of Kenya. The reason I push it by is to build their self-image and to help also their students to develop a positive self-image that will make them thrive not only in education but also in life.
All right, thank you very much, Bonnie Kim, for talking to us today on our book review. Your book, The Power of Self-Image for Successful Students. Thank you.
You're welcome.